Hello, I'm Artifactsofmars. As you can see, I'm at the local laundromat. I had something to say to modern love and suffer Christians. I'm going to try to center my camera a little bit. Alright. Now what brought this on? This has been simmering for a long time now. Make no mistake. But what brought this on was somebody posted a thread on YouTube. Something where she's saying God is in control, don't worry about this stuff. To which Artifactsofmars says, BS. And why do I say this? Now, the first thing you have to understand is that I'm an agnostic. Got that? Agnostics believe that we're just not sure what to believe. I have my reasons why I'm an agnostic today. But I saw this and it triggered me, even though this has been building for a long time. So I'm going, what on earth? You mean to tell me that, you're going to sit there and say that God is in control, huh? Well, look at the mess this world's in. Is your God or any other deity solved any of this world's problems? Shake your head no, because they haven't. Be that as it may, the primary thrust of this video is to discuss why Christians think it's somehow chic or, important or desirable. Yeah, I know it's in your Bible, but you should be made to suffer. I consider it to be just evil, because anybody would be persecuted like that for their religious beliefs. I don't care whether it's Christian, Muslim, Taoist, I don't care. But, what is all this based on? All this is based on the execution of Jesus Christ. Utterly barbaric. 100% inhumane. You all know the story, I'm not going to go into it. Jesus was executed like this, but he was never persecuted, at least as far as you can read in the Bible, until that day when he was murdered. The Christians have somehow taken this story to mean that it's okay to suffer because Christ suffered for us, and so we all need to suffer for him. Well, I said Christ suffered for a day. A day. Some of these people are suffering for decades, not one day. Now, I'm going to ask you, what does a Christian, what does a father do if he catches some dirtbag messing with his kids? Well, most fathers are going to beat the tar out of them. And what does you say that we're God's children and that, someone running in a Chinese prison, for instance, for their faith, they're a child of God? Really? What does your God do about this? The answer is zilch. He doesn't send down the angels and, to zap the prison guards and say, okay, you're out of here. He doesn't send down an angel to whatever government, Chinese, Burmese, whatever. He doesn't send down anybody to say, okay, mess with my children, you're going to get it. Doesn't do that. Your god does nothing. Period, then the subject. This really breaks on it. Because Christians think that it's okay to suffer like this. I don't think so. I think it's horrible. I think it's inexcusable. Unfortunately, it really is the way it is. You shouldn't aspire... You should aspire to help people. Any religion should aspire to help people. I don't care what your religion is. That should be its primary thing. Help the poor... help the disabled lady down the street, can't shovel her own snow. Then bring your message to them. That's what it should be doing. Unfortunately, we have very evil people in this world who would silence that. That's all. As it was in days of Christ, it's political. It's always political. Because these scumbags don't like having their power usurped by a god that they can't see, can't detect, and can't sense. They don't like it. And so they throw Christians, Buddhists, Taoists, whatever, in prison. I don't have any statistics on persecution of any religions or anything. I know persecution of Christians is on the rise. And Christians think that it's a badge of honor to suffer for Christ. That's where I take issue. I don't think it's a badge of honor at all. I think you should be pushing with all your might to demand these heads of these countries change to a religion-friendly format. But unfortunately, Christians don't do that. They just go break the laws of these countries and they go and suffer and they think it's a badge of honor. I do not think it's a badge of honor. Quite frankly, I think it's a badge of stupidity. I know you gotta do your religion. I know this country's getting more and more unfriendly to Christians. I understand that. But, we need to change the system. We have a Muslim in U.S. Congress, I forget what her name is. She's causing quite a stir. Then you have socialists like, OAC, socialists by definition, are atheists. You can't be a member of that political system and have religion at the same time. It doesn't work that way. Socialists, communists are by definition atheists. If you are a socialist and you think you have a religion, you're in conflict with your own political beliefs. That's that simple. Alright. So, as far as I'm concerned, it's not alright to suffer. And hurt and all that. I don't consider that to be alright at all. And I'm more than dismayed that Christians sit there and wear this for a badge of honor. It's not. We can't stop it. But your God sits back and does nothing. This is my point. Now, what would Artifacts do if he had godlike powers, which he obviously doesn't? I don't have any special powers, which I did. They're all which we did. I'm not Yoda. I'm not Luke Skywalker. I'm not Darth Vader. I'm just Artifacts. What would Artifacts do? Alright. Hypothetical scenario. prison. People being held there for their political, Christian beliefs. I go down, say, okay, you're letting them out now. Guards raise guns, guards fire. This is if I'm a guy. Guards fire, zap, 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 zap. Then I go up to the prison camp commander. You're letting the Christians go. You're going to apologize to them. Because they raise their guns, pop, pow, pow, and I go, zap, 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 zap. That's what a real father would do. A real, godfather, father god, whatever. Your god does nothing, and this suffering goes on for years and decades. Sorry, I can't live with that. There are other reasons I'm an agnostic besides this. This is one of my things. Like you have an entire denomination called the United Church of Christ who was seeking to destroy the white race. I can't live with that. We've been all through this in Nazi Germany. But if your godfather was loving God, he would take care of this and he wouldn't allow this type of persecution. Yet all I hear are Christians, Christianity should be enjoyable, it should be something where you can lead your life and you have this guy that has your back. But instead all this is about suffering and pain and crying. And we're supposed to think that because Jesus Christ was brutally murdered, that every one of us has to suffer year after year in Iranian prison camps or Chinese prison camps or whatever. Which I say, fuck. Now, you're going to tell me that your God is so powerful he can throw me in a burning prison forever and ever. Then I have to see this God do something about these situations. Not sit there and talk about it. Not sit there and encourage it. It's like you said, you're in prison. Okay, you let these Christians go, you're going to apologize to them, you're going to pay them reparations, guards pull guns, pow, 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 zap, 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 zap. You know, guard on tower, pow, 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 zap, zap, zap. Prison camp commander, zap, 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 zap. And they're out of there. Local officials send the police, round them up. Zap, 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 zap. That's what a real father would do. A real father, if he is all powerful, would go into these countries and put an end to this. But your father, God, doesn't. So how am I supposed to take these threats of hellfire and brimstone and whatnot seriously? Other than the fact that I've soul traveled a few times to the other side and it's not all that scary. But how am I supposed to take that seriously when your God sits back and doesn't do anything? He doesn't go into North Korean government. Say, okay, you're freeing up these people. Because they raise their guns, pow, 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 and the guy goes, zap, 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 zap. Doesn't do that. I would say that religion in general is not just Christians either. I mean, Taoist god, whatever it is, doesn't do it. Hindu gods don't do it. Pick any religion you want. including Islam. Their people were persecuted in Islam. Where's Allah? Prison guard goes on. Okay, you're letting these people out. No, we're not. Pop, all pop. Zap, 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 zap. I mean, why not? Nobody's God does this. I'm not unloading entirely on Christians. By any means. So, now to wrap this up, I really think that Christians need to consider what's going on. I think your primary goal should be to help people get together, help little ladies on the street. Can't shovel her own stone. And talk to her about a loving God. But you also need to realize that this is more of a metaphor, I believe. I'm an agnostic. I believe this is largely just a metaphor. Because we don't see this going down. We don't see this happening. Where your God is going in and putting an end to this persecution. And that's including in the United States. You didn't see, I can't remember this dirtbag's name, the one who shot those black folks in that church. He's accused of shooting him. What's your God done about that? Answer is nothing. Nothing, nothing, nothing. You only have one word to describe all of your God's actions in this. That word is nothing. So, I think we need to consider religion to be more metaphorical, a way to explain our human condition. And I think we need to take more responsibility for our own species. But don't talk to me about hellfire and brimstone when your God won't do a blasted thing to help out in situations that I just talked about. Don't even talk to me about this. Because if he's not powerful enough to do anything about this, then he's not powerful enough to throw me in some burning prison for all of eternity. If he can't send down an angel to liberate one prison camp, I'm thinking about the prison camps of Nazis and Jews. He can't send down one angel to liberate these camps and zap those who persecute his own kind. Then he's not a terribly powerful God at all. I'd say probably more metaphorical than anything else. And why did your God allow millions to die in Russian prison camps, Nazi prison camps, so on? Why did he even allow that? We need to consider religion to be more of a metaphor than anything else, I think, and use it as a tool to help people who really deserve, need the help, rather than trying to proselytize religion. I think that's my main point here. I thank you for watching. Don't stop praying. I mean, have at it. Don't matter to me. I'm for religious freedom. So don't stop praying, but you should consider your religion to be just that, a religion. A metaphor for the human condition. I'm Artifactsofmars. Again, I thank you for watching. Have a nice day.